Hello, Brian McCarthy here from Bold&Break. Excited to be sharing a very fun, quick tip with you today. We are going to be looking at a way to make this very generic motion graphics Instagram abstract animation. Have a look. Okay, let's get started. Press Shift C and type in flower, or you can access the flower spline from the spline panel here, or tab, whatever you like to call it. Then come down to our spline here. And then what we're going to do is we're going to press Shift C again, type in formula. We are going to put this formula under our flower, and it's all deformed. It's a very sad flower, but we can change that and slow it down. We go into our formula object. We amend this formula here. Now, we're not going to get too into the formula, whole separate video. To slow it down, I'm going to just change that to 1, and that should slow it down quite a bit. And there you go. More floaty, a bit more happy. What we're going to do is we're going to call this formula underscore Y. Duplicate this, Control C, Control V. Bring this under. I'm going to change this to spherical. You might say, why are you putting two formulas? Form this, and you'll see in a minute. Press Shift C again, bring in sweep. Then we again want to press Shift C in circle, put our flower under our sweep, and put our circle into our sweep object, but we want to bring it below flower. And there you go. The hierarchy here is very important to get right. Now we play this, this lovely slow animation happening, but we want to kind of rotate the object. The object rotated in the preview I showed you, so we gotta make the object rotate here. Now we're gonna do this without any keyframes. I'm gonna right click, go to animation tags, put in a vibrate, enable rotation, bring our frequency down to 0.1, bring our rotation to 260, change this to 30, change this to 90. And we haven't set one keyframe. This very cool animation. And the beauty of this is it's pretty modular, change things. Now, just to show why there are two formulas in here, we are going to go back into our formulas. We're going to change this from formula Y to spherical, SPH. If we turn off this, you can see in the middle part of this animation, this kind of juts out. That will stop jutting out as much. So you get that kind of middle bit jutting out, which is why I added that extra bit. You can see here, it juts out if we turn off our Y formula, which is quite cool. If we want to change this, amend it, we can add more ridges, and we can even amend our sweep here. If we wanted to take the scale down and do some cool stuff. That is it. That is super quick, super easy. Let me know, is understanding the formula object something you want to do more of? Is that a tutorial worth doing? Hope you enjoyed that. Please like, subscribe, leave a comment below. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.